jak się czujesz?
Dobrze, dobrze, jak zawsze.
No zawsze?
Tak.
No i mamy kolejne włosy zrobione. Chciałem wam przedstawić mojego asystenta, to jest Emil.
Dzień dobry, cześć. Mam na imię Emil, jestem ze Szwecji. Mówię trochę po polsku, bo ja mieszkałem w Polsce od kilku lat, ale z moimi pacjentami ja mówię po angielsku albo po szwedzku. Jeżeli masz problem z włosami i myślisz o przeszczepie, zapraszam do Dr. Ossoff Clinic.
Hair transplantation, I did it for about 10 years.
Yeah.
And in my practice, I've been using a strip technique.
Yeah.
So I was cutting the piece of the skin from the occipital part, suturing the wound, and the nurses were taking the grafts from this. And with the stick and place technique, these grafts were put in the place that where they should be.
Yeah.
And where's the difference in your technique? Because you like the FUE, so it's something new for me. So tell me more about this.
With the FUE, which stands for follicular unit excision, I'm using an electrical drill, and I'm targeting individual follicular units in the back of the head usually. There are other donor areas, such as below here, and you can use some of the beard or chest hair if it's very bushy. And the difference is that I don't get a linear scar. And nowadays it's very trendy to have shorter haircuts like I do. And with the FUE, you don't get a visible scar, so you can go with shorter haircuts without it being noticed. And it's very aesthetic, I think.
Hair transplantation, I did it for about 10 years.
Yeah.
And in my practice, I've been using a strip technique.
Yeah.
So I was cutting the piece of the skin from the occipital part, suturing the wound, and the nurses were taking the grafts from this. And with the stick and place technique, these grafts were put in the place that where they should be.
Yeah.
And where's the difference in your technique? Because you like the FUE, so it's something new for me. So tell me more about this.
With the FUE, which stands for follicular unit excision, I'm using an electrical drill, and I'm targeting individual follicular units in the back of the head usually. There are other donor areas, such as below here, and you can use some of the beard or chest hair if it's very bushy. And the difference is that I don't get a linear scar. And nowadays it's very trendy to have shorter haircuts like I do. And with the FUE, you don't get a visible scar, so you can go with shorter haircuts without it being noticed. And it's very aesthetic, I believe.
You told me a few times during the surgery, let's do combine. Let's combine the FUE and the strip technique. So I'm wondering, because it's something new for me to use the both methods on the one patient at the same time.
Yeah.
How can you imagine this?
Well, it's medicine is always evolving, and with the hybrid technique, then first we do FUE drilling on the back of the head, but we save an area about this size, and we save it for the strip, where you take out that part of the scalp, and then when we do this, we can get out many more grafts and we can perform mega sessions. And this is usually done for patients, both men and women, who have severe hair loss.
So the main advantage is that we can get more hair.
Tell me more about the online consultation, how it works.
The online consultation, it works that the patient sends me an email where they send pictures from the front, on the sides of the head, on the top of the head, and on the back of the head. And then they tell me what they want to have done. Either want to fix their beard or their head. And they have to tell me their expectations, because patients need to be really realistic. Sometimes they're not. And sometimes I have to make them realistic with what they can achieve. After that, I talk with them about pricing, how to
prepare
with blood works, booking hotel,
flights,
everything. I'm helping them out with all the needs.
Chciałem wam przedstawić kilka pytań, jakie dostaliśmy ostatnio od naszych pacjentów.
Ponieważ dużo konsultujemy online, pewne pytania się powtarzają, stąd chciałem przedstawić Wam te najbardziej częste. Emil, so I grabbed some questions that we got last emails
yes.
from patients, and let's try to answer them.
Sure.
So the first will be, when can I observe the first effect after the heart transplantation surgery?
It will come after a couple of months. You will notice small hair growing out, not a lot, but with time, with months coming, more and more hair will grow and it will get denser. The full result will be out after a year, and then you will see thick, dense, very good looking natural hair.
It's after the year.
After okay. a year, you will have a natural.
Do you observe any trends about people in other countries? Some. Because I found that with a new style as yours.
Yeah.
So some young guys asking for some better hair on the bare area.
Yeah.
Is it possible to do this with FUE? Does it
of
work?
Of course. Yeah. I noticed trends, mm-hmm. especially now. It's very trendy to have a thick lumberjack beard. Yeah. And especially from people from the Middle East, it's sort of a, I must have it. Mm-hmm. And people have been contacting me regarding filling in their patchy beards or mustaches or covering areas where they have scars, either on the face or on the head. And I am very for this. I'm very for beard creation, putting a beard on someone who hasn't had the ability to grow a beard before.
So that's a big trend.
I love it. It is, mm-hmm. and actually I like it.